Hello guys, good morning from Dhaka, Bangladesh. Welcome back to the channel. Hopefully you're doing good. I've just uploaded a fragrance review, basically list. I was planning to do another review later part of the day, but I feel like, you know, let me do the review right now because it's very, very cold and early morning. It's very, very foggy. Everywhere it's like very, very cold. It's like 15 degrees. And right now it's very windy. So you can feel the chill, and I want to do a very special fragrance review for you from the rooftop. I'm holding the mic. I'm speaking very low because time is pretty early. It's around 6:30 in the morning, and very, very foggy, and man, I'm freezing. Not really freezing, but it's very cold. So I have a little bit of a cold problem, so I'm really geared up. So the fragrance I'm going to be reviewing is the new Rasasi line that I'm reviewing. This is the third one. I think I've done the Oud and I did the Luban one. So first one, I think Oud one was inspired by something like mostly Shura or a Tobacco Blaze, but more polished version. But the second one, I think it was similar to Moschino Toy Boy. The third one I'm going to be talking about is called Worth Noir. Okay, so this is one of their more luxury line, 200 ml bottles, very fabulous presentation. And I'm holding the mic once again so you can hear, because if I speak low, then maybe the sound will not be good. So and the thing is, like, the workers are not waking up just yet because of the cold. If they start waking up, you'll start hearing the noise, they'll start the work, so you can't hear the things properly when I say something. So first thing, this 200 ml, they are priced different little bit, okay? So different countries, have seen UK sites, they're selling this for £180, okay, or something like £185, yeah, like that. So it's expensive, but our country, you buy these, I think you can get this from authorized distributor of Rasasi, MMC Luxury Perfumes. They are selling this for $80 odd, so excellent value for money, $40 per 100 ml. So this thing, what you get is that magnetic box. Sometimes the magnet, you know, it's like difficult. Yeah, but it is magnet, not the strongest magnet I would say, but this one you have to find the right side, you know, it doesn't really close everywhere magnetic. So this is pretty solid. I really like this about this presentations. The main focus will be the bottle, but inside it's a bit of cheap feel, you know, this part, it's not really posh, but it's okay. So I appreciate the magnet. And there are other information, 2023 release. The bottles here are like our work of art. I should have done this review like later part of the day, like maybe afternoon, but that time sun would be out, but also there will be a lot of noise. But if you can still see, it got that purple juice that is similar to another fragrance also from Rasasi. I'll show you and I'll tell you a story. And I think these bottles are everything, man. These are the most luxurious looking bottles so far I've seen from Rasasi. The magnetic cap is very, very strong. This one has like Lancome Oud Bouquet kind of style bottles, and also YSL Tuxedo style bottles. So some people may say it's inspired by them, I don't know, but I really love these caps. Okay, the sound is so satisfying and it's very strong. I mean, don't play with it that much because bottle is heavy. Bottle is very heavy, do not play with it. But the juice color is very attractive. I used this, the first one I used from this line was this. I got the whole line. The fragrance is in my hand. Okay, let me respray and show you the spray a little bit. You can spray a little like this. Okay, really smooth spray, pressured. Also you can spray a lot. Okay, so excellent spray. So this one has notes on certain sites, but I'm not sure how accurate they are, but I'll tell you, I got notes like, I think blackcurrant, think pink pepper, rose, sandalwood, vanilla, maybe patchouli, and some of the other notes I think they were listed. So basically what I'm telling you, this one, someone said, I sent them the decant, I'm decanting this, and they said they got a feel of Rasasi's Darish, which is another purple looking juice, very similar looking, and I'm wearing this in my right hand. I'll compare these a little bit, but they are quite common notes between the two, and I could see why he compared them. I think the first thing that came to his mind was, let me hold the perfume, man, very cold. You know, my sister has the garden behind, so her, some of her big, you know, these plants, they fell. I have to fix it after the review. So this one, let me tell you, it's a little bit different. It's not the same as, like, you know, imagine Shura versus the Ud, the other one from this line. They are not the same. There are definite differences, definitely in the opening. This one has the black currant, which is very fruity. And then main player in this is Rose, okay? So whole line is kind of like a unisex. This one, I think it's a perfect unisex fragrance, like ladies can wear it just like the men. And this one will really be perfect for this kind of weather. Colder months will be beautiful. So this one also has a powder effect, but the main difference between this and Darej, I would say Darej is bit more beast mode, okay? If you see, I just showed you just now. Side by side, they're both purplish. Same looking color, but I think this is a bit more nice because the bottle, and these are very heavy bottles, by the way, okay, very, very heavy. So Darej, it's more spicy in my humble opinion, even though this one has pink pepper, the word noir, but this is more sweet, this is more spicy. And Darej, people know that Darej is a clone of Valentino V, that fragrance, which I never tried, but I really love this. And cold weathers, Darej, Shura, these two fragrances are the best. Beast mode, sweet. This is more of a sweet, sexy, masculine perfume. I think this one has cardamom perhaps and a bit more black pepper. The rose, patchouli and the vanilla are common with Word Noir. So this is the similarity between Darej and this. It's like the rose, patchouli and vanilla note, but up top they smell different. This is my Word Noir on my left hand. My right hand is Darej. Darej smells more of a spiced winter, like something that you want to wear like somewhere in Christmas, a bit more spicy, you know, compared to this. Darej also reminds me a little bit of Rojas mustache, but this one reminds me a little bit more of that Rojas mustache, Roca's mustache, EDP, that vanilla, you know, but this one doesn't have any booze. So the rose is so beautifully done. This is such a smooth, polished fragrance. Longevity is good, but this line, I noticed the whole line does not really project more than 1 hour, and they stay close within like 2 to 3 feet. So that's one thing, maybe some people it'd be a deal breaker, but again, look at the price point. You can get this cheaper than Hawas per 100 mil if these are being sold $80 in your country. But I'm pretty sure, sad thing, different country like US and Europe, by the time it reaches you, because of the weight, because of the packaging, because of the taxes and everything, this is gonna be a lot more than what I paid. So do not quote me on the pricing. Bangladesh, if you want to get, if you happen to be in Bangladesh, if you stay here, or if you want to collect it from our shop MMC, I'll leave a link below, you can buy these from them. I think this offers excellent value in every way possible, the whole line. One thing is the packaging, the bottle, the magnetic cap and the box, then the juice color, the smell, all four are fabulous. All four of them are collection worthy, and these definitely feel higher class despite not being as beast mode as Darej. Darej to me smells very good, very high class, very sexy, sweet. But if you compare this with Word Noir, what I smell in Word Noir is so much more polished. It smells so much of more quality. And I would say for this cold weather, man, for this kind of weather, evening time, night time, even daytime, if it's a little bit chilly, this fragrance would be so, so, so good. It's very sexy, very beautiful. And my most beautiful, most favorite bottle design from the line because of the juice color. So where can you wear this? I think this would be perfect wear for daytime, evening time, very versatile even. Even I would say this rose is wearable in maybe in summers, but where it's not so hot, maybe the spring or a little bit of a rainy monsoon, you know, that would be perfect. This one can be worn for your anniversary, wedding programs, you know, dates, or even if you go to bed, just a couple of spritz on your pillow or your neck. Beautiful fragrance for that. It's a beauty, you know, it's more than a beast, it's a beauty. So longevity and projection, I'll give it an 8 out of 10, like performance wise, price value wise 10. This, you cannot beat the pricing of this beautiful, amazing presentation and the smell. For the smell, I'll give this 9 out of 10. Versatility, about 8.5. Then age range, this one can be worn by anybody really. Like some people say Darej is more like a spicy gingerbread cookie, you know, like a spice latte sort of smell. This one doesn't have the spice, so I would say this is more age appropriate, like for 20s and above. Then Darej is like a more of a 30 plus, you know. Some people did not like Darej or Shura, so this is not really a wild fragrance. This is more suited up, more polished and upper class. So both genders can wear it, and I think 20 plus is the right age range. You can wear this at maybe I would say signature scent, and there's no review on this, active review so far I know of, but soon there will be. When reviewers get this, the whole line will be reviewed. Perhaps they will not be as excited as I am, because I love Rasasi. Rasasi has like, I have many Rasasi reviews on my channel, because I started falling in love with them like since Shura and some of the other ones, and I think this fragrance does really, really amazing job. So it's up to you, but I would say do not blind by this, okay? Because the rose note, if you ask me to kind of criticize, if you do not like fragrance like Portrait of a Lady or something that has rose, pear, kind of like a floral note, maybe it will be not for you. Maybe you'll find it a bit feminine and a bit powdery, because the vanilla dry down, you know, and the blackcurrant actually is very, very beautiful. The opening 15-20 minutes is amazing, fruity, but after that, the rose affair. So remember, the rose patchouli combination is not for everybody. So get a decant, get a sample first, then you see if you want to get the full bottle or not. But I know many people get this just for the bottle, the whole line, you know. Overall, my 2 cents on this one, like initial impression, I'm giving this a fragrance like a 9 out of 10. One of the most beautiful ones. And I'll review the amber, review for you the amber one, the last one, amber something, forgot the name. That one is gonna be also very, very good. Thanks for watching. I think I'll go for morning walk, and let me show you one last time. Like, I just absolutely love this weather. If you see background, sorry, people are hanging clothes and stuff. It's Bangladesh. So if you see at the back, very, very nice fog. And what happens is, as the sun comes up, this thing's gonna be like, the weather is gonna be a little bit sunny, but it'll stay pretty much cool throughout the day, but as not as much of how to say, the fog. So the fog for me is like that, okay? When we used to be young, we used to play cricket and stuff during this season, early morning, you know, go with the trip with the car or the van or the university bus. That was time of our life. So this kind of weather, I appreciate. Some of you asked me, like, let me finish on this note. Some of you asked me, like, 15 degrees, it's a joke. In Canada, it's like summer. I understand. But if you leave, I humbly ask you, come visit our side of the world, and you'll see why I appreciate. Most of the year is 42 degrees and stuff. It's horrible, heat and humidity, dust, noise. This time it's really pretty, even though a lot of flu and dust as well, but also we enjoy not sweating and walking a lot, so people stay active, enjoy a heavier food. So this is why winter is beautiful. Check out the fragrance, and if you happen to be in a subcontinent, enjoy the winter as much as you can, because it won't last that long. Take care, have a nice day, I'll see you soon, bye bye.